you actually surprised at this point?
Short people got no reason.
Randy Newman. Punchline to me and my friends. And I crush on him? I could talk about the music he wrote as a solo artist, where he would often use sarcasm when writing about grim topics.
But are they grateful? No, they're spiteful and they're hateful. They don't respect us, so let's surprise them. We'll drop the big one and pulverize them.
But I don't think I would do him justice. There have been, like, plenty of better writers who talked about it, and I'll give a link in the description, including this one piece from Vice News that I like.
I'm kind of in love with Randy Newman.
Me too. What I am a subject matter expert on is knowing what I like, and I really, 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 really enjoy his music. Oh, and that he's cute. So how did I get into him? I mean, that's the question everybody asks. The most me thing ever. Listening to video game music and watching a video on how the PCM channel on the Sega Genesis works. The songs they use as an example of their sampling capabilities was Strange Things from Toy Story. I think he inspired some other video game composers too. Just take a listen to this. After that, I decided to listen to him and watch a bunch of his videos, and y'all know what happened next. I have to say, there's a lot of good stuff of his. I was expecting, like, more of the same, but there's so much I like.
Like another perfect day. I love LA.
Trouble in Paradise is my favorite album of his so far. Of course, one of my favorite songs is the one he wrote for Toy Story 2.
And when she was sad, I was there to dry her tears. And when she was happy, so was I. When she loved me.
I never cried at movies as a kid, but when I heard that song, I was like, I was in tears. I specifically remember being at my grandma's house and just sobbing. It's, you know, it's amazing how a song can do that. I think it's great that he can write for both kids and adults, but it's still a little bit jarring when you hear sweet old Grandpa Randy sing lines like this.
Baby, take off your dress. Yes, yes, yes.
All right, Randy, if you say so.
Hoo-cha-cha-cha. Hoo-cha-cha-cha.
So yeah, it's strange how I'd find him, of all people, attractive. But this is me we're talking about. Oh yeah, and he also did the music for one of my favorite non-Disney features, Cats Don't Dance.
Seems like everyone's sailing way out on the sea.
Yeah, that one keeps coming up here again. I love that movie.
While I go shoehorn myself back into my dress, let's talk about this guy for a second.
All the world seems in tune on a spring afternoon when we're poisoning pigeons in the park. Every Sunday you'll see my sweetheart and me as we poison the pigeons in the park.
It was queued on my YouTube for like weeks and I didn't bother to listen to it until a month later. It turns out I did hear him before. I vaguely remember hearing a National Brotherhood Week as a kid.
National Brotherhood Week, National Brotherhood Week, it's national, everyone smile at one another, hood week, be nice to people who are inferior to you.
Because my dad had the album and he let me have it, which is pretty neat. So I looked to see if he did any live performances and holy cow, I actually got to see what he looked like. I mean, come on, the glasses. But he's also brilliant and funny, and that's why I like him. Just listen for yourself.
I ache for the touch of your lips, dear, but much more for the touch of your whips, dear. You can raise welts like nobody else as we dance to the masochism tango.
Smut! Give me smut and nothing but a dirty novel I can't shut if it's uncut and unsubtle.
I went to Harvard at like 15. It's pretty darn impressive. Also, he's still alive. He turned 90 this year. So is he a single? No, I'm kidding. Come on. So I thought this was it. I've reached peak crush levels. Nobody could replace him. But of course, I was wrong.
Ave Maria, gee, it's good to see ya. Getting ecstatic and sort of dramatic and doing the Vatican rag.
The crush that followed no continuity.
Continuity?
I assume after liking Randy Newman, I'd crush on things, you know, moms listen to. Journey, Billy Joel, Bruce Springsteen, Steve Uh-oh. I'm amazed how I missed out on him because he's good. Really, really good.
Baby, I know. Baby. Yes, I know. I can't stand.
I've been listening to him for a few years. I just never knew what he looked like. That's the pattern I follow, I swear. And he sounds just as good now.
Look inside your heart, look inside mine. Things look so bad anyway. They plowed, they've sown, they've harrowed him in through clods upon his head.
Also, look at the dog. His name is Twiglet. Twiglet, that's the cutest name for a dog I've, ever heard. Then, of course, I got another crush faster than you can say John Barleycorn must die.
John Barleycorn must die.
Yeah, Ray Liotta, he's hot. And I'm thirsty. Also, he has such a good laugh. I was watching a review of one of my favorite YouTubers, Brows Held High, and he reviewed Revolver, and that's how I first noticed Ray Liotta. I'm notorious among my family and friends for not watching too many movies like everybody else has seen. So yeah, I'll get back to you on this after I watch Goodfellas. I saw B-movie, though.
I also see from your resume that you're devilishly handsome, but with a churning inner turmoil that's always ready to blow.
I enjoy what I do!
My brain moved on to something else because the next one is a doozy. Okay, so here's my favorite part of the episode last year. So I'm gonna predict who I'm gonna be obsessed with the rest of the year. This one isn't a prediction, but I already started obsessing over him while I was editing the episode. So here we go. Yep. Billy Joel. I mean, I've liked him forever. I never actually fangirled over him until now. I don't think there was a time where I didn't hear one of his songs, no matter where I went. I think it's also because I grew up in New York. Now, I completely redact my statement about, things moms listen to because I love him. I, really don't care that he's, 70. I don't. I really don't care now. Oh, I think it was also because I remembered how much I liked Oliver and Company. He was my favorite character, Dodger.
What'd I tell you guys? Dodger can really pick him.
Why should I worry? Tell me, why should I care?
One of my other favorites is in that movie, too, but we'll get to that later.
It's just a fantasy. Ooh, it's not a real thing. Sometimes a fantasy.
Thomas Dolby. I've listened to him forever too. I've listened to him since college, but I didn't get obsessed with him. But yeah, he's really cool. In last year's episode, how I mentioned Dean Stockwell, well, I only saw pictures of him when he was older. I never saw what he looked like back in the day, and how he's gorgeous. That's all I got.
Ooh, chabu-cha-cha. Ooh, chabu-cha-cha.